गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई थिंक वी आर टेकिंग द नेक्स्ट लेसन क्लास फॉर आवर माइंड्स एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ आवर माइंड्स. लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ आवर माइंड्स. नाउ वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ आवर माइंड्स. नाउ इन दिस देयर इज सर्टेन लैब टेस्ट, लाइक इन द लेबोरेटरी ऑल्सो वी कैन डिटेक्ट द basicity of amines. Okay, now the test which we can take in the lab is test for amines. Like you all know that amines are basic, all amines are basic compounds, they are bases, and aqueous solution of water soluble amines actually turn red litmus paper blue when you have the aqueous solution of amines and you dip the red litmus paper in that, it turns blue. So from this you can detect whether it is you can find that this is a basic compound. Is it clear? Now what all like we can do to detect the basicity of amines in the laboratory is reaction with aqueous solution of mineral acid. Earlier we were talking about water soluble amines, now we are talking about water insoluble amines. So how we are going to detect? We are going to detect by using the strong mineral acid. You all know the nitrogen atom in amine has a lone pair of electrons which can be donated to a suitable acceptor like proton for the formation of a coordinate bond. See the reaction where RnH2 is a primary amine which is insoluble in water. It reacts with concentrated mineral acid, that is HCl, and the proton forms like nitrogen donates its lone pair to H plus, and we have the formation of a coordinate bond, and the compound which is formed over here is a substituted ammonium salt, that is RnH3 plus Cl minus is a substituted ammonium chloride, you can say. Now see, I have shown you on the screen where the electron pair or the lone pair of electron which is present on nitrogen is shifted, or it goes and attacks H plus and forms a coordinate bond. Now amines also acts as a Bronsted-Lowry base as it accepts a proton. Now earlier what we have talked, like lone pair is donated to H plus, we can talk in reverse, like a proton can be accepted, so then it is called as a, since amine accepts a proton, so it is called as a Lowry-Bronsted base. Now ammonium salt, when it is treated with base like NaOH, generates a parent amine. Now earlier we had a reaction with HCl where you got a substituted ammonium chloride or substituted ammonium salt. Now this substituted ammonium salt reacts with NaOH, and like now this substituted ammonium salt actually is soluble in water. Now it reacts with aqueous NaOH and you get your amine back. So this is again a test to detect the basic nature of amines, which I have given it in the points. A water soluble amine was given to you, it reacts with dilute HCl and forms a water soluble substituted ammonium chloride, which on reaction with excess of NaOH generates the original insoluble amine. Clear? Now the next chemical reaction which we are going to study is diazotization reaction. Now this diazotization reaction is also called as orange dye test. Now what actually is happening in this reaction, see, or how this reaction is taking place? A sample of primary aromatic amine is taken. To this sample, 1 to 2 mL HCl is added. The solution HCl which we are taking is a concentrated HCl. You have to cool this solution, and to this solution we are going to add an aqueous solution of NaNO2, that is sodium nitrite. You know, this whole reaction is carried out in cold conditions, that is around about 0 degree centigrade temperature. Now this solution which is obtained is added to another test tube which is containing beta naphthol in NaOH. Now when you add this solution to beta naphthol in NaOH, you get an orange dye stuff. Now this orange dye stuff which is obtained over here is actually the detection, that it is actually used for the detection of a primary amino group in aromatic amines. Okay, now whenever we are going and taking these classes, I really want that you all should have your notebooks or your notebook and a pen with you, so that you can make the notes, and if you have any problem you can contact me on my WhatsApp group. Now next chemical reaction which we are going to study is alkylation of amines. Now this name, alkylation of amines, it is also called as Hofmann's exhaustive alkylation. Now Hofmann's is the name of the scientist. Now why it is called as exhaustive alkylation, we'll study. Now what is happening in this case? This reaction we have already studied, you'll come to know as we go further. We have already studied in methods of preparation. So now what is happening? The replacement of a hydrogen atom attached to nitrogen in amines by an alkyl group is called as alkylation of amines. Now you all know the structure of amines. It is RNH2, or if it is a primary amine. Now when I say RNH2, the hydrogen is removed, or it is replaced from, which is attached to nitrogen, by an alkyl group. So since an alkyl group is substituted in case of the hydrogen which is attached to nitrogen, we call it as alkylation of amines. Now here excess of alkyl halide is used. Since excess of alkyl halide is used and it is exhausted, so we call it as exhaustive alkylation. Now in this case what is obtained? Tetraalkyl ammonium halide is the last product which is obtained. But when I start this reaction from primary amine, I get a secondary amine, and from secondary amine I get a tertiary amine, and lastly from a tertiary amine I get a tetraalkyl ammonium halide. Reaction is known as exhaustive alkylation of amines, as I told you earlier, since excess of alkyl halide is used and we have exhausted it so it is called as exhaustive. And since hydrogen attached to nitrogen is replaced by an alkyl group, it is called as alkylation. Now this reaction is carried out in presence of a mild base. Now why this mild base is used, let us see the reaction first. Let us come up with the first reaction. You can see I have taken an example, I have taken a primary amine, that is methylamine. Methylamine reacts with methyl iodide, and where the hydrogen atom from the dash NH2 group is replaced by a methyl group, and I have the formation of a dimethylamine. You see nicely on the screen, from methylamine, that is primary amine, I am getting a dialkylamine, that is dimethylamine, which is a secondary amine, and HI is liberated. So since so much acid is liberated, to neutralize this acid we are using the mild base, that is sodium bicarbonate. Now let us go with the second reaction. In the second reaction, the dimethylamine or the secondary amine which is obtained reacts with another molecule of methyl iodide, and you have the formation, the last hydrogen which is left on the dash NH group, or the hydrogen which is attached to nitrogen is again replaced by a methyl group, and I have the formation of a tertiary amine. Now this tertiary amine, since it is a trimethyl amine, is obtained, and again HI is liberated. Now in the last step, the tertiary amine which is obtained over here in the second step, it again reacts with another molecule of methyl iodide, and I get a quaternary ammonium salt. The name of the salt, if you want, you can write the name of the salt, or otherwise you can write it as quaternary ammonium salt. The name is, since four methyl groups are present, it is called as tetramethyl ammonium, and it is a substituted ammonium salt. If you see nicely, if I have ammonium halide or ammonium, for example ammonium iodide I have, so all the hydrogen atom which are attached to nitrogen, that is NH4, are replaced by methyl groups, so it becomes tetra alkyl ammonium iodide. Okay, now here I have a question for you. You see on the screen, I have taken the same type of reaction. Now instead of methylamine, I am taking ethylamine and an ethyl iodide. So what product I'll be getting? I'm using excess of C2H5I. Similarly, in the second step, I'm taking a diethyl amine or a secondary amine, and here also I'm taking excess of an ethyl iodide. Now I just want to make some things clear over here. Like when I use the word excess, and I have written, I am starting with a primary amine, please pay attention towards first reaction. I have written ethyl amine and I have written ethyl iodide, which is used in excess. Now when ethyl iodide is used in excess, all the hydrogen atoms which are present on the nitrogen are replaced by ethyl group. So a primary amine is converted into a secondary amine, secondary is converted into a tertiary, and tertiary is then again converted into a quaternary ammonium salt. No, I just want to make one thing clear over here. Ki, like if I'm starting with a primary amine, I require 3 moles of an alkyl iodide, that is ethyl iodide, to form a quaternary ammonium salt. And if I consider the second reaction, means for if I consider the second reaction, it is a secondary amine. Secondary has to be converted into tertiary, and from tertiary amine to quaternary ammonium salt, it is only a two-step reaction. So I require only 2 moles of methyl iodide. So students, please remember over here, for one step I require, like if I want to convert primary into secondary, I require 1 mole of ethyl iodide, and from secondary to tertiary again I require 1 mole of ethyl iodide, and from tertiary to quaternary I require again 1 mole of ethyl iodide. So in all, for the first reaction I require 3 moles of ethyl iodide, and similarly in the second reaction I require 2 moles of ethyl iodide. Is it clear? Now I have already shown you like I've given you the questions, but I have also presented the answer for this. You can see the answer on the screen. In the first step, one mole is used. In the second step, 1 mole is used. And in the third step, 1 mole is used. So in all, from a primary amine to a quaternary ammonium salt or a tetraethyl ammonium iodide, I require 3 moles. And similarly, when I talk about the second question, I'll start from the second reaction and end it to the third reaction. Okay? Then the next chemical reaction which we are going to study today is Hofmann's elimination reaction. Now again here, it is the name of the scientist who first detected this elimination, so it is called as Hofmann's elimination reaction. Now what is happening over here? A tetra alkyl ammonium halide, which we got in the earlier reaction, you can say, is heated with moist silver hydroxide, or you can say it is a moist silver oxide, actually gives you quaternary ammonium hydroxide. Now this, they are the deliquescent crystalline solids. Quaternary, now from this, like you can don't misunderstand, they means quaternary ammonium hydroxide are the deliquescent crystalline solids which are strongly basic in nature. This quaternary ammonium hydroxide on strong heating undergoes beta elimination. When they undergo beta elimination, you get an alkene. Okay? The major product which is obtained is the least substituted alkene, which is in contrast to Seisser's rule. Now see the reaction on the screen. I have an ethyl trimethyl ammonium iodide, actually it is. I have ethyl trimethyl ammonium iodide. So make a correction. It reacts with moist silver oxide. Silver oxide suspended in water behaves as like AgOH, and when you actually it undergoes a hydrolysis reaction where you have the formation of ethyl, trimethyl, ammonium hydroxide, and AgI is liberated. So please make the correction in the name. It's written chloride. You have to make it iodide. Now, the second step is ethyl, trimethyl, ammonium hydroxide, or the quaternary ammonium hydroxide, which is obtained, is heated at a higher temperature, and you have the formation of an alkene and a trimethyl amine. Now see this last reaction nicely. All the three alkyl groups, that is the methyl groups which are attached, they do not have beta hydrogen. Whereas if you see the ethyl group, the carbon which is attached next to nitrogen is called alpha carbon, and the carbon which is attached to alpha is called as beta carbon. So a hydrogen atom is removed or eliminated from beta carbon, and I have the formation of an alkene, that is ethene. So here, as we said, ki we get the least substituted, but in this case, actually, in the alkyl, the other three alkyl groups, there is no beta carbon, so possibility of other option is not there. Now let us take one more example so that I can make the things very clear. Now I have the another example which is already solved in your textbook. You can go through this and accordingly you can contact me. Now this structure is actually a NN triethyl. Now here three ethyl groups are attached: propyl, ammonium, iodide. Now this is again a quaternary ammonium salt. It reacts with moist silver oxide suspended in water, or it is heated with this. I think I had given you a question mark because I want you to solve, but I am just giving you a hint. Now if you see nicely on the screen, the alkyl groups, three alkyl groups are ethyl groups and one alkyl group is N propyl group. Now if the elimination, now in both the like alkyl groups, whether I talk ethyl or I talk N propyl, both are containing beta hydrogen atoms. Now the problem is ki like which alkene I should get. Now as I told you earlier ki this elimination is in contrast or is opposite to Seisev's rule. This is again a beta elimination only, but I get a least substituted alkene as my product. Now in this case I will get ethene, because ethene is not having any substitution, but if I get propene, it is a mono substituted alkene. So my preferred product over here is ethene. So please solve this question. I think it is already there in your textbook, it is solved in your textbook, so please go through it and let me know. Now the next chemical reaction which we are going to study today is acylation of amines. Now first of all, what do you mean by acylation? Before we could go, what is an acyl group? Now replacement of a hydrogen atom attached to nitrogen in amines by a acyl group is called as acylation. Now you all know the structure of amine, okay? Now when I say amine, you know, you will say it is RNH2 accordingly. Now when I say NH-NH2 group, it's an amino group. So I'm talking about the replacement of a hydrogen which is attached to nitrogen, that is on the dash NH2 group, by a acyl group is called as acylation. Now what is an acyl group? See, I've given you the structure on the screen. Dash C double bond O CH3 is called as an acyl group. This is also called as acetyl group. Amines reacts with, now how actually this acylation is taking place? Amines reacts with acetyl chloride or acetic anhydride in presence of a strong base, that is pyridine. Now here this reaction is carried out by taking two different reagents. You can say one is acetyl chloride and another is acetic anhydride, and in presence of a strong base. Okay, now what do you get by this? Amines reacts with acetyl chlorides. I actually get an acyl or a acetyl derivative of amine, which is formed, and it is also called as an amide. So please see the spelling of both the things, like reactants and the products. Reactant is an amine, that is dash NH2 group, and the product which you are getting is actually the acetyl derivative of amine, and it is called as amide. Now these amides are less basic than amine. Now why they are less basic, I'll show you during the reaction. I'll tell you about that. Next important point which you have to remember over here is, it is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Aliphatic and aromatic primary and secondary amines undergo acylation. Now please remember this part. Aliphatic and aromatic primary and secondary. See, I'm specifying again on this word, as it is primary and secondary. Means I have not written the word tertiary. Means tertiary amine do not undergo acylation reaction because hydrogen is not present on the nitrogen in case of tertiary amine. So only the primary and secondary amines undergo acylation reaction. Now let us see the reaction on the screen, where if you see nicely on the screen, I have taken the structure of a secondary amine. In case of secondary amine, we have two alkyl groups which are present on nitrogen and one hydrogen atom is present. Now this one hydrogen atom which is present can be substituted or replaced by a acyl group. This reaction is carried out with acetyl chloride. This is also called as ethanol chloride, where I replace, since two carbons are there, we call the parent is ethane. I remove E of an ethane and put ONYL chloride. So this ethanol chloride. If you don't remember acetyl chloride, you can write ethanol chloride. Now the amine which I have, the IUPAC name which is given, or otherwise you can even write dimethyl amine. Now this dye and the nitrogen, you all know a lone pair of electrons is present. See, I have given in arrows. This lone pair can go and attack on a positive species, I mean to say. Now C double bond O, in case of C double bond O in acetyl chloride, since oxygen is more electronegative, the pi bond is shifted towards oxygen and it becomes negatively charged, and carbon becomes positively charged. So this lone pair or nitrogen forms a bond or a coordinate bond with the carbon, and you get the structure which is given on the screen. In the next step, HCl, if you see, in the next step HCl is liberated and I get an amide. Now how HCl is liberated? The NH bond is still intact, and on the nitrogen we have a positive charge. You all know that nitrogen carries a lone pair of electron. Since electronegativity of nitrogen is more, so the electron pair between nitrogen and hydrogen bond is shifted on nitrogen, and hydrogen is removed as hydrogen atom is removed as proton. Okay, so a lone pair is coming. On the next part of the same structure, if you see, O minus electron pair is again transferred from O minus, and a pi bond is formed. So you have a structure that is C double bond O, and a Cl minus is liberated by taking its electrons, both the electrons. Okay, so the structure I get is an acetyl amine, you can say, but properly I want to give an IUPAC name to this structure. It is actually a acylated derivative of secondary amine, so I write it as NN dimethyl. Now since two carbons are there, 1 and 2, so the parent is ethane. I remove E of ethane and write the suffix amide, so it becomes ethane amide. And on nitrogen we have 2 methyl groups, so I have written NN dimethyl ethane amide. Clear? Now I think earlier I told you one more thing, that these are less basic than amines. Now why amides are less basic than amines? Because they are involved in resonance, so that is the reason they are, their lone pair is not available easily. It is involved in resonance, so it is less basic. Since lone pair is not available, for the compound to be basic, the availability of lone pair should be more. So here lone pair is not available because of resonance, so it is less basic. Or as in case of amines, that is dimethylamine, it is easily available. Clear? Now I have one more structure. Taking into consideration the same reaction, that is acylation, or the same reaction I have, and the structure is of methylamine. Now here again I have taken a primary amine, earlier I have taken a secondary amine. Now this primary amine you can see in the reaction. Now I don't want a two-step reaction, I can directly also write the reaction. Here you all know there are two hydrogen atoms which are present on nitrogen. So methylamine reacts with acetyl chloride, where one hydrogen is replaced and you have a acetyl group which is attached, and HCl is liberated. So the reaction takes place in presence of pyridine, which is a strong base, so that HCl can be neutralized. Now the compound which is formed over here is again an acid amide. You can even call it as, like, it is at the end position you have a methyl group attached, so it is N-methyl acetamide, or even you can write N-methyl ethane amide. You have to remove E of the ethane and put the word amide. One more reaction I have of the same acylation. Now I have taken so many reactions because I want you to clear with the questions of your competitive exams also. So please go through this. Now here I have, as I have already told you, the aliphatic and aromatic amines undergo this acylation reaction. I have the structure of aniline, which is also called as benzenamine. You all know this very well because we have already studied the IUPAC nomenclature, where I told you ki aniline or benzenamine, both the names are accepted by IUPAC. Now this benzenamine reacts with acetyl chloride in presence of pyridine, where one of the hydrogen attached to nitrogen is replaced by an acyl group, and you get the structure which is given on the screen, and HCl is liberated. Now what name you will give to this compound? First of all, name is already written, but I'll just make you very clear ki C double bond OCH3 actually is a parent, so it is an ethane amide, because the functional group, when a functional group is attached, so the NHC double bond CH3 is the parent, because NHC double bond O is a functional group, where now here the alkane is the parent, so it is a two carbon compound. I'll replace E of the ethane by the suffix amide, and on the N position I have a phenyl group, so it is called as N-phenyl ethane amide. Now the next chemical reaction which we have to study today is Hofmann's carbylamine test. This is also called as isocyanide test. Okay, now again this is by the name of the scientist. Now in this case, aliphatic or the aromatic primary amines on heating with chloroform and alcoholic KOH, they give you a compound which actually, when you carry out this reaction, you get a foul smell, or you get a very bad smell is obtained when a primary amine, whether it's an aromatic or aliphatic, it reacts with chloroform and alcoholic KOH, you get a very bad smell. Now this bad smell is actually the indicator that an alkyl isocyanide is formed. Okay, so it is also called as carbyl amine. The next part which you have to remember, ki only primary amines, whether they are aliphatic or aromatic, undergo this isocyanide test. Tertiary and secondary amines do not give this test. So please remember this part. You can get the question for your exam ki why, like, these two are not giving you this test. Only the primary amine, or which amine undergoes the Hofmann's carbylamine test. So you have to click on primary amines undergoes the Hofmann's carbylamine test. Now let's see the reaction where a primary amine reacts with chloroform in presence of alcoholic KOH, they're heated, and you get a structure which is R-NC. It is actually a carbyl amine, which is a alkyl isocyanide. Okay, KCl is liberated and the water molecules. Similarly, I can show the same reaction with aniline. Aniline undergoes carbyl amine test with co-chloroform and alcoholic KOH. I get the structure like this is the carbyl amine which is obtained. And what you have to remember over here is like you get a foul smell, which is an indicator that an isocyanide is formed. So today we are going to stop here. Thank you. We'll continue in the next lecture.